All right, YouTube, what's happening? I got a package in today from Wazoo Survival Gear. Where's that box at? Damn, where's that box at? They have really cool packaging I was gonna show. So, oh, here it is. Check this out. So instead of just a regular old cardboard box, they send you this guy, and it's got all this cool branding on it. Welcome to Wazoo. Bug out bags are great, pockets kits are too, but the only survival kit that matters is the one that's over there with you. So they really build their kit around hideable EDC things. That's kind of like their idea. They have the cash cap, they have this belt, all kinds of cool stuff. So I thought the packaging was neat. So what I got was the cache. I see there's going to be debate in the comments how you say that. Is it cache or is it cache? So I'm going to say cache just because cash sounds too much like money, you know, cash money to me. But I ordered the Wolf Gray one here in a medium, and I'm a 34-inch waist, and it's really actually a perfect fit. Like, there is a little bit of adjustability, and I do need to tighten it a titch, but I could always trim it if I wanted to. I don't think I'm needing to. I'm just going to leave it alone. So it works out really well. Wore it today for the first time, so I already have some experience wearing it. But I ordered the belt, and I ordered your essentials kit. So essentially all this gear is gonna go inside that belt, which is really, really cool. So let's look at the belt. It's a pretty, almost like a seatbelt type material. It's not very rigid. If you are gonna carry this with a gun, they do recommend that you reinforce it. And I'll show you a few ideas I have, things I have handy. But you could also get a piece of Kydex, cut it in, plastic, whatever, to kind of reinforce for a gun. I did that today. I carried it actually without any reinforcement, and it actually did fine. I was at a baseball game for the last couple hours, and it was fine. Like, I didn't really notice it, but it definitely wasn't, like, rigid. And that's not necessarily a negative thing, right? But it wasn't, probably wasn't rigid enough, I guess is the way to put it. So I have a solution I'll show you in a minute. But to get into the belt, it's made right here in the USA. Really high quality. I can tell the stitching is really well done. But essentially what this is, it's a, like, I don't know if you've ever seen those old money belts, but there was a way to hide money in belts, and they kind of just took that idea and ran with it. So you have Velcro all along here. From essentially here to here is one big pocket. There's no, like, little dividers. It's all just one area, all the way back here. Now, I've got some items in here. I have a little mini sear kit with, and it's just kind of all chilling there, with a handcuff key, plastic, so you can't, doesn't, you know, if you want to carry this through metal detectors, you could. I've also got some lock picks and some, a little cutter here to cut zip ties, in case you were detained, I guess is the idea. I've had it for a long time, so I threw it in there, and it carried, I didn't even notice it. So obviously that's not included in this essentials kit. I already had this stuff, so I'm going to kind of do both. The idea of the essentials kit is more of a survival full sear kit for survival as well. This is kind of more urban, you know. This is more, I'm out in the woods and I need to survive, and I have some items on me that I could survive with. So kind of best of both worlds here. You could kind of set up two different kits if you wanted to, and just on an EDC basis run that, and then, you know, if you're gonna be outside camping, whatever, you could throw these things in, or you could just leave it all in there at the same time. But the pocket goes all the way around, so you get tons of space. So so you could easily make this stuff yourself and not need to buy this kit. But the nice thing about this, we're just gonna open it up together, is how they packaged it. Like, when I mean that, I don't mean this plastic bag. So you got a couple zip ties, which should be handy. You got some tape here. Duct tape, or Gorilla tape, whatever. We've got some cordage here, all already wound up. Which, again, a lot of this stuff you could do yourself. What's cool is this stuff here, I thought, was what really caught my eye. So what they've done is they've shrunken down a lot of this stuff into very small packages. Like this, you've got, is this fish line? What is this? Technora cord, 25 feet. No, that's probably this. Fishing line. It is fishing line. Okay, so I thought so. So yeah, it's a fishing line, but notice how it's all in a plastic, it's like in a straw that's been sealed. So it's not gonna just float around, it's just gonna sit in there nicely. You've got a water bag with some water purification tablets and some Ranger bands. That's key, that's huge. Having something small like that, they've already got a package nice and small for you. And then they've got your, you can keep all this together, or you could separate it, but you've got some fishing, like some sinkers there, and some hooks, and a safety pin, plastics, tube sealed, again, that little straw. So I really like how they did that. So to me, it was worth it. Plus, I bought it for this video, so. So you got some fire plugs, and you've got a ferrocene rod here with striker, which is ceramic, so it won't dull very easily, which is nice. So a ceramic striker, ferrocene rod, and then you've got a whistle. So really survival items, not necessarily urban survival. You might probably not going to need to start a fire in an urban scenario. You might, never know. But you know, you might need to collect water. There you got that. Probably not gonna do fishing, but again, this is kind of a combination of both kits. Is what I wanna do is I wanna put all this stuff in this and just kind of show you how it works and how I positioned it and then wrap up it up. So stay tuned. Got all that stuff in there. It's definitely a lot thicker belt now, especially like in this area here, which is fire steel, fire plugs, all that. And then I've got some area over here with a cordage, it's a little thicker. And then I noticed the duct tape, like it kind of doesn't fit all the way. So it's pretty good. So there's a little gaps, which is gonna happen when you have this much stuff on your body at one time. That's a lot of gear to be hidden into a belt, right? And I did add some things, like added the hand kiff and lock picks and those kind of things. So there is some additional things, and there's probably some things I'm going to take out. But just to give you an idea of what the belt looks like, fully loaded with the essentials kit. Is that what they called it? Yeah, essentials. There's also another kit available, a little bit more expensive. Has a few more items in it too. But this is what the belt looks like without all that in there. So you can see, I kept this stuff in the packaging. I took out the whistle, got that separately. I may just separate these things, because it may be less bulky that way. And there's some additional fire tabs, like different fire tabs, I think that would work better, that are thinner, flatter. So you could kind of save some space there. So I do recommend this kit that they give you. It has got everything you need and then some, but you might save a little space by going, see, look, when I, yeah, maybe it's because I got both fire plugs there. So that shuts. A little bit bulky there. A little bulky here. That's the water bag with purification tablets and the Ranger bands. That one doesn't quite fit. It's like right up to the line, so you just kind of really... The idea is not to have anything that kind of like pushing out like that, right? You can get everything in here, but it's pretty snug. I mean, yeah, it seals pretty well. So, yeah, really cool. All the stuff you can carry in a flipping belt, guys. This is nuts. You're going to have this on your body every single day. You have a belt. Who doesn't wear a belt with their pants? Especially if you carry a firearm like I do, like a lot of you guys do and watch my channel on a daily basis. Why not? Okay, so speaking of that, a few solutions. Before I forget, one other cool feature that I forgot to cover is they have this little inside the buckle. It's designed, first of all, this is a bottle opener, so you can open your bottle pretty slick. This is designed in the buckle to carry a signal mirror, but you could also stash some cash in there. So if you want to have some emergency cash on you at all times, it's just gonna sit there right in your buckle. No one's gonna know you have it. No one's gonna be the wiser. So pretty cool little compartment there that you can put stuff in as well. All right, since this is not rigid enough, in my opinion, to carry with a gun for a long period of time, there's ways you could improve that. I took this piece from my Agonic EDB belt, which is just a piece of, I don't know what this stuff's called. It's the same stuff that the Neomag uses, Alias system uses. Same exact kind of stuff. Now this is cut a little thinner. This is a little too thick. I was gonna think, oh, you could use this, which you still could. I'll give you a solution with that in a second. But this piece came from the Agonic belt, and I could just weave it through here, use the keepers that aren't included, and then I've got a nice piece of rigid, I always have the belt buckle to the right a little bit, so I've got this rigid piece to clip my belt, my gun onto. So that works well for me. You're not going to always have that, right? And you don't want to go out and buy a $100 belt just to get this. They don't sell this separately. So another good solution I thought was either the Neomag Alias system. If you run that, you can just clip this on to your belt. It's meant to be obviously used without a belt, but you can easily use it with a belt and clip it on there, and then you can attach your holster through that. Or my preferred method, I think, is the Leisure Carry that I just recently interviewed. So I kind of always just have my holster attached to this, so that way if I want to carry without a belt, like in shorts, like gym shorts or sweats or something like that, I can just throw this on. Or if I want to run my belt, I just throw the belt on, and then I just clip this on, you know, to the belt, and then it hides the clips that way, and it gives me that rigidity I need, and it's really comfortable. So that's kind of been my solution. I've got the Leisure Carry already, I've got the Neomag. If you don't have those things, you don't want to go out and buy them, this is $60. It's got multiple uses, right? You're not just using it for this belt. You could also just get a piece of Kydex and cut it down, or even just some sort of stiff plastic. But I do think it needs reinforcement. For me, I already had those things handy, which is nice. So it's easy for me. Like I said, I think I prefer the Leisure Carry or the little piece that came with the Agonic belt, but the Leisure Carry is gonna be more accessible to everyone. It's $60. If you buy the 11.5-inch one, if you want a smaller one, don't carry a sidecar, then you could do a little bit cheaper one. And then when you wanna carry this, you just clip it on there and you're good to go. So yeah, I'm gonna try this out all fully loaded up and see how it feels. All right, so I've got the belt on. It's got everything in there. It doesn't feel weird or anything. It kind of bulges in a few spots, but it's very noticeable. I've got the Leisure Carry on there. You can see the clips now kind of sit behind the belt, which is cool. And I've got my holster on here, and it's plenty sturdy. Not gonna move around, feels very comfortable too. So it's a nice solution. So if you want to carry more gear on you at all times and just kind of not have to worry about it and always know you're going to have that peace of mind that you have some of those items on you, this is a great solution. All right, so kind of a few final thoughts here. So one thing I noticed while wearing this all packed up is that you can access anything at any time. That's one of the big advantages, right? You can open this up and get to it while it's on your body. You don't have to remove your belt. So you want to position the things that you want easily accessible up front. Now I carry, again, I'm going to have the belt off to the side like this. I'm going to have that Leisure Carry or whatever support system here for the appendix carry. So this pocket and this pocket are going to be my front pockets, right? So right now I have the tape. Probably going to not need tape, you know, frequently, right? On this side, I've got a fire steel and stuff. Okay, I'm not going to need to, if I need to start a fire, I can take my belt off, right? But there may be a few items like the escape and evade things, like, you know, that I might want easier access to, that I might want up front. A lot of guys keep a handcuff key in the back in case their hands are behind their back, but there's different ways you could do that. So I want to put things that I think are a little bit more accessible, where I can get them in the front. So I'm just gonna have to like kind of play around with how I set things up. Also think I'm gonna ditch the cordage. It's a lot of cordage, for some Kevlar cordage. I have some of that here in my other belt, and Kevlar cordage is nice because it can use as a saw, so you can cut through things because of its properties. So all that got all tied up. See, this is the advantage of buying it in a bundle like this, but that's got a twisty tie and I just need to do that. So I've got some Kevlar cordage here that I had in my other belt that I'm just gonna utilize instead. It's a little less bulky, so I'll put that cord in it like a EDC kit, you know, kind of like a survival kit that I have in my truck or whatever, not necessarily on my body at all times, but I'm gonna replace that. So that's one solution, that's the Kevlar cord. That's what I'm gonna do as an alternative to that. But other than that, like the setup, like I said, I might go smaller on the fire starters. I've got the, forget what they're called, Dave Canterbury makes them. They're like in a, they look like a little flat waffle, and you can just tear them in half. Those are gonna be flatter than those round ones, and they are just as effective. They're really, really good. So yeah, if you can get your cordage kind of smaller like that, and then just use a little twisty tie like that. So I'll probably do that. So I'm gonna eliminate some of this bulk in here. Might take the tape and I don't know. It's really handy to have that kind of stuff on you. So it's hard to say what to carry and what not to carry, right? But, you know, most of the time, and I am in an urban, and, oh, see, here we go. If you kind of just get it under that lip right there, then you can, maybe, thought I had a solution here. Yeah, we can kind of close that up, but I don't think I'll need access to that tape. Well, I could see tape being useful, but, you know, a lot of these survival items, I won't need access to them directly in front of me, you know, so... just kind of move those around. Oh, it was this water purification bag too. That was like really accessible. I'm like, I don't really need that up front. So I'll probably just move some stuff around, make some adjustments. When I do, I'll kind of do a separate video with how I have it loaded out. But it'll take some time playing around with it, see how it feels. But I really like this compact striker. That's great to have on you. Again, I'm going to go flatter on these so it's less bulk. Yeah, there's some ways I'm going to kind of change this out a little bit. But really, really cool product. Glad I bought one. It's going to be my everyday carry belt, especially because I figured out a solution to carry a gun with it. And yeah, I would love to see them make it, you know, for some device, do something like this that Agonic did with their EDB belt and just kind of add that as an insert there. And you can just, because what you do with this, so this is kind of more for the Wazoo guys for the future, is you just... This goes through here in this keeper here. You could do something very similar to this. Doesn't have to be the same, obviously. And then you just, this piece usually goes on this side here. So there's a little elastic keepers. I like the laser carry because I can just leave my holster on that and I can use it both ways. But, you know, I'm thinking for future designs of this, you could do something like this where that kind of piece is removable, but it's also there in the front. So it adds some rigidity where you want to carry your gun. So anyway, guys, that's going to be the wrap up of this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.